Hello all, I'm Sindhu C. In this video lecture, I'll be discussing about k-means clustering. There are several clustering approaches like partitioning methods, hierarchical methods, density-based methods, grid-based, model-based, clustering high-dimensional data, and constraint-based clustering methods. In partitioning approach, we construct various partitions and then evaluate them based on some criteria, like minimizing the sum of square errors. There are so many algorithms under partitioning approach. The most commonly used partitioning algorithms are k-means, k-medoids, and clarins. The basic concept in partitioning algorithms is, first, we have to construct a partition from a given database. Say there is a database D with n number of objects in it. We'll have to set the number of clusters that is to be made from that database. So from that, we'll be constructing the partition with respect to minimum sum of squared distance. So given k, which is the input, k number of clusters, we'll have to find the partition of k clusters that is optimal. And this optimism is based on some kind of criterion. So first, the very first paper written on k-means was by McQueen in the year 1967, where each cluster is represented by the center of the cluster, which is basically the mean. Having said that, now tell us, what are the inputs for the k-means clustering algorithm? Please give your answers. Here is the answer. So k-means clustering algorithm takes in two inputs. One is the data set, which contains n number of objects. The second is you have to define how many number of clusters is required. So that is k number of clusters, and d is the data set containing n number of objects. So here comes the k-means clustering method. So the number of clusters is the input, which is k here. Given the number of cluster k, we have to implement it in four stages. Partition the objects into k non-empty sets, which is randomly you will be making three clusters with some randomized data in it or random number of objects in it. Then we'll be computing the seed points as the centroid of the clusters of the current partition. So here the centroid is the center, which is the mean, which gives the name k-means clustering. Then the third step is assigning each object to the cluster with the nearest seed point. Again, this will be iterated going back to the second step, and again it keeps repeating, and until there is no more new assignments, these steps are iterated again and again. Here in this leftmost grid, you can see there are some data points. The input given to this is k is equal to 2. So we are going to finally make two clusters. Now we are assigning each objects to some similar clusters. So in the second grid, you can see that we have randomly made some two clusters. Then we have to find out the cluster means. So in the third grid, you can see the red points. They are the cluster means. Now in the fourth grid, they are reassigned based on the mean points. Again, this will be updated based on the mean point. Clusters will be updated. So which is the fifth grid. So again, it goes back to the second grid, and again, the iteration keeps changing the cluster assignment. So this keeps repeating until there is no new assignment. This is the k-means clustering method. The strength of k-means method is it's relatively efficient. You can see the comparison. It's O of TKN for k-means, and for PAM and Clara, which are two other partitioning algorithms. So k means is better, where t is the number of iterations, k is the number of clusters, and n is the number of objects. We have some drawbacks. So this k-means is applicable only where the data objects can be computed with mean points. So it is not applicable for categorical data. So for categorical data, you have to convert it into something else, and then you have to go back to calculating mean. Again, you need to specify k, which is the number of clusters, at the starting of the process. Then it is difficult to handle noisy data and outliers using k-means method. And it is also not suitable to discover clusters with non-convex shapes. Thank you.